Hey guys, I'm Nikhil, your TeachPad instructor, and in this After Effects tutorial, we will learn how to create a really nice and dynamic looking slideshow animation in After Effects. So without any further ado, let's get straight into the tutorial and get started. Alright, so here we are in After Effects, so let's start by creating a new composition. This is gonna be our main comp, so let's rename this to main. 1920 into 1080, 30 frames, 10 seconds, and hit OK. And now I'm going to create a new composition for our media placeholders. So you can anytime drag in a different image or video to use. You don't need to do the exact same thing again and again. So let's rename this to media. Hit OK. And let's create one more composition. And this is going to be our scene 1 comp. So let's rename this to scene underscore 01. And let's rename the media to underscore 01 as well. Alright, so there we go. Just to be a bit more precise, let's create a group for images and drag in our images into that group. Let's create a folder for media and drag in the media into that folder. Let's create a folder for scenes and drag in scene 1 into the scene folder. So now we have something like that, just to be a bit more organized. Alright, so the first thing that I'm gonna do is into the scene 1, go into the media 1 composition, just double click on it, and drag in whichever image that you wanna use. You can also use videos as well, depending on your preference. So I'm gonna drag in the image and scale this down a bit, cause it's a fairly big image, maybe somewhere around there. And let's add some text as well, so let's type in something like dynamic. You can of course type in anything that you want. I set this to maybe around 160, around 160 should work good. And align this in the center. Maybe I'll set this to 200 pixels. Really big and nice. And to add a bit more flavor to it, I'm gonna add some strokes. So select the rectangle tool, set the stroke pixels to 10 and drag in a rectangle just like that. And let's align this in the center just like that. So now we have a bit more nice looking scene right over here. Then what I can do is go into scene 1 composition and drag in the media 1 comp into the scene 1 composition just like that and scale this up to 110% just like that. And then what I can do is basically go ahead and create some shapes. So select the rectangle tool. We don't need the stroke, we need the fill. So let's set this to any color that you want. I'm gonna set this to gray and create some random shapes just like that. Maybe something like this and maybe something like that. And I'm doing it pretty randomly. You can take your time and create some really nice and complex shapes as well. So as you can see right over here, I have five different shapes. So let's hit Control A to select them all and hit U to close them all just like that. And then I'm going to duplicate the media 1 composition 5 times. So now we have, you know, each comp for each shape layer. So let's drag in the shape layer 2 about the media comp, second media comp, drag this right over here and this just like that. So now we have each shape for every composition. As you can see, let's select the media compositions just like that by holding control and set the track mat to alpha mat. So as you can see, nothing happens. So what we need to do is go to, let's say around, let's go to 2 seconds, select the media compositions again and hit P to bring down the position properties and click on the stopwatch to create a keyframe. Go back in time to, let's say 1 second. And now what I can do is start to displace the composition, media composition. So I'm going to displace this to, let's say, somewhere around there. Select the second one, displace that even a bit more, something like that. Third one, displace that, maybe something like this. And I'm doing it really randomly. You don't need to be precise while doing this. You can take your time and create any kind of look that you're going for. So I'm going to do it a little bit maybe. So let's see what we have. Select this one, let's drag this a bit, just like that. So So now we have something like that, as you can see. Okay, this is looking pretty cool. Let's select all the keyframes and hit F9 to ease those keyframes. So now we have something like that. And then what I can do is go into the main composition and drag in the scene 1 composition just like that. And we can go ahead and animate this comp. So let's go to 1 second, hit P to bring down the position properties, create a keyframe, go back in time, and let's drag this up just like that. So now we have something like that, as you can see. Maybe I'll just bring the keyframes a bit more closer. So let's select all the keyframes and let's bring them down to 20 frames, somewhere around there. Let's go into media comp and let's see what we have. Okay, pretty good. Let's select the keyframes, hit F9 to ease those keyframes, go to graph editor. And if your graph editor doesn't look like this, make sure you're working in the edit speed graph and not in the edit value graph. So let's select this keyframe and let's drag this handle just like that. So now we have a really nice and cool looking animation, as you can see. Yep, that is looking pretty good. Maybe I'll do it a little bit subtle. Yep, as you can see, looks really, really cool. So it's the main idea behind creating this kind of slideshow. So now what I can do is, to create more slideshow, what I can do is select the scene 1 and the media 1 composition and hit Control D as many times as you want to create slides. So I'm going to create 3 slides. So I'm going to, you know, do it Control D 2 times to create 3 copies. So now we have 3 media comp copies and 3 scene comp copies. And now what we can do is go make sure you're in the main composition and drag in the scene 2 and the scene 3. Let's drag it just like that. And let's displace them by maybe 1 second, or maybe let's go to 2 seconds, somewhere around there. So now we have 2 seconds, and at 4 seconds, I want the third scene just like that. And now what we need to do is open up the scene composition, just select them all and double click on it. So it's going to open all the scenes and also the media composition, just select them and open them up. And then we can replace them with a different image that you want, or you can also use a video, as I told you guys. So let's drag in the second image, scale this down a bit, and also change the text to something. Maybe you can type in, of course, anything that you want. You can also drag in a logo if you have one. Let's go into third one, delete this, and drag in the third image that you have. Scale this down a bit, and let's rename this to something. Let's call it stylish. Okay, so now we have our 3 media composition. Let's go into the scene 2 and replace the media comp 1 with the media comp 2. So select them all by holding Control. Select the media 2 comp, hold Alt, and just drag them over them just like that. And they are gonna get replaced just like this, as you can see. The same thing for the third scene. Select the media compositions by hitting Control. Hold Alt, select the media 3 composition, hold Alt, and just drag this on the top, and it's going to replace them just like that. So now we can go ahead and try to, you know, come up with a different shape. So to do that, what I can do is select them, hit U so we can see the keyframes, and delete these keyframes just like that, and hit Delete to delete the keyframes. And this time I'm going to select the shape layer and drag it to the right. So something like that, not the shape layer. I'm going to select the media composition, and this time I'm going to drag them to the right. So let's drag it just like that. Select the second one, drag it even a bit more, maybe somewhere around there, something like this. And there we go. So now we have a really nice and different kind of look. And by the way, you can also change the shapes of the comp. So you can also change the shapes of the shape layer. So you can change, I can select a different shape if I want to. So just something like that, maybe. Make sure the anchor point is in the center, just to be a bit more precise, and make it something like that. Different shape, like this maybe. And you can also drag the shape up if you want to. And creating some really nice and abstract shapes just like that. So now we have a little bit of more randomness to the scene, as you can see. looks really, really cool. Maybe I'll change the shape. It's not looking that good. Maybe make it a bit bigger. Yep, this is looking really, really nice, as you can see. So let's go into the main comp and let's animate the composition. I'm gonna also change the scene 3. Let's bring this on the top. I'm the scene 2 to 2 seconds and scene 3 to 4 seconds. There we go. Also change the animation of the scene 3. So let's select the compositions, select all the layers, hit U and go right over here. Just delete these keyframes. And I'm gonna also change the shapes just to be a bit more, to make it look a bit more complex, you know. Maybe something like that. Depending on your preference or what kind of look you're gonna go with. Something like this. Something, let's center this up and drag it something like there. And there we go. So now what I can do is I can select the media composition and drag this to the bottom, something like this. And just do it really randomly. But make sure it looks cool. And there we go. Okay, so this is looking really nice. Okay, so this is looking pretty good. Let's select keyframes, hit F9 to ease those keyframes, go to graph editor, and let's create a curve like this. Okay, that is looking pretty good. And do the same thing on the other two scenes as well. Hit F9, go to graph editor, select these keyframes and drag the handle just like that to create a curve like this. And scene 1 as well. There we go. Let's go to main composition and let's animate this compositions basically. So let's place it right over here. Hit P to bring down the position properties. Let's go to 3 seconds maybe. Create a keyframe, go back in time to 2 seconds and let's drag them out just like this. And the same thing for the third scene as well. And you can create as many scenes as you want. Let's drag this to the bottom. Make sure it's out of the frame. Select the keyframes, hit F9 to ease those keyframes and drag it, creating a curve like this. Let's see, hit U. And yep, let's drag it even more. So let's see what we have. Yep, looking pretty good. Maybe this is a bit too fast, so I'll just hit F9 and just make it a bit smooth, something like that. See? Yep, now it is looking pretty good. Yep, that looks cool. Let's hit Control A to select them all and U to close them all. And now what I can do is let's retouch the scene a bit. So let's create a new adjustment layer. Let's rename this to CC for color correction. And let's add some basic curve adjustment just a touch. Just like that. To make the scene pop a bit more, as you can see, without and with. Let's add a vignette pretty quick. So let's duplicate this, hit Control D. And let's rename this to V for vignette. Let's reset the curve. Make it a bit darker, just like that. And select the ellipse tool. And just double click on it. Invert this up. And feather this up by hitting F to bring down the feather properties and set this to around 600. And then I can go ahead and tweak the circle a bit. So maybe I'll just bring this a bit closer. And we are done. So as you can see, it is really simple and easy to create a really nice and dynamic looking slideshow. So let's wrap it up for today. I hope this video was helpful to you guys and I'll see you in my next video. Till then, take care and thank you so much for watching.